our amnesty. As a welfare measure and in order to give an opportunity to power consumers to prevent disconnection and to facilitate easy payment, the council has approved an amnesty scheme for all power consumers, domestic, industrial, institutional. The amnesty scheme shall come into effect from March 1, 2020. The scheme envisages payment of all arrears in three easy installments. 25% of the payment to be completed by March 31, 2020. 40% by April 30, 2020 and the remaining by May 31st, 2020. On timely and complete payment of all the installments, a full waiver of interest and penalty shall be provided by the department. However, in case consumers miss the first installment, they will have to forego 5% of the benefits. Similarly, those missing the second one will have to forego 10% of the benefit. And failure to pay all the installments by the appointed date, that is May 31st, will lead to disconnection. It is also clarified that after the 1st of June, power will not be supplied to defaulting customers unless the arrears are cleared in full. It is estimated that waiver of penalties and interests, as I have just explained above, will cost around 600 crores to the government. So the amnesty scheme actually envisages a waiver of 600 crores and facilitates payment of all arrears, that is principal, in easy installments. This amnesty scheme is meant to facilitate the recovery of a total pending dues of around 3,000 crore rupees. The second important set of decisions pertain to the Industries and Commerce Department. The Administrative Council discussed in detail the difficulties being faced by local industry. After detailed discussions in the Administrative Council, the Honorable Lieutenant Governor directed the Finance Department to prepare an estimate of the interest liabilities of industries operating in J&K owing to the situational difficulties being faced by these industries. The Finance Department will carry out a detailed exercise in consultation with the Industries Department and any other department that it may feel necessary to consult. The Finance Department will also prepare an estimate of the forbearings required to see that the local industry can be revived and start functioning normally. Another major decision which was taken today was that the Administrative Council asked the Industries Department to engage in widespread stakeholder consultations in order to prepare a policy for incentivizing local industry on similar lines as is being done for attracting investment from outside the state. These consultations by the Industries Department will eventually lead to a comprehensive package for having a vibrant industrial and tourist ecosystem in Jammu and Kashmir. The Administrative Council also reviewed the state of the proposed Global Investment Summit, which is scheduled to be held shortly. As part of the preparations for the summit, and if I may say so, in the run-up to the summit, the Council approved sector-specific policies for four sectors in order to help Jammu and Kashmir attract investment in these four sectors. As you are aware, we have identified 14 sectors as focus sectors for attracting investment, and sector-specific policies for each of these 14 sectors are being prepared. Four sector-specific policies were approved today. The remaining are in the pipeline. They are at various stages of preparation and will shortly be approved. The Administrative Council also took note of the fact that an enthusiastic and encouraging response is being received from potential investors. And in order to facilitate the entire process of attracting investments, a lot of background work is required to be done. It has therefore approved the creation of the post of an Industries Commissioner in the Industries Department in the Pay Matrix 14.